Our body has a main axis which may be branched or unbranched, and this axis bears dissimilar structure called lateral appendages. And the plant body is differentiated into two parts, root system and shoot system. Okay, and the root system bears root and its branches. Likewise, the shoot system bears stem, leaves, flower, shoots and seeds. So if you take the example of a plant body, okay, here, likewise, here the leaves are supposed to develop. So this axis, this main axis is known as main axis. This axis is main axis, or otherwise called as mother axis. Okay, main axis or mother axis. And from this axis, it may be branched or unbranched. And the mainly the plant body is divided into two types. First one is root system, and second one is shoot system. So the root system is our underground part, and shoot system is our aerial part. So first one is our root system, root, because the on the basis of morphology and function, plant has a following parts. Just different parts. Roots, shoots, stem. Okay. So we just study one by one. First one is root. Non-green underground part. Okay. It is the non-green underground part. And root develop from radicle. From the radicle. The seed has the radicle part. Okay. The radicle, in the radicle part, the main root is developed. And the main root also called as primary root or tap root. Okay, remember this one. The main root which developed from the radicle is known as primary root or tap root. Then it bears lateral branches. So from the lateral branches, the secondary roots develop. Okay. And the secondary root develop in a particular manner, that is acropetal succession. What is acropetal succession? The youngest lateral roots are nearest to the apex, okay, and the older part is progressively further back. Okay, the youngest part present at the apex. Okay, youngers are developed at the apex, and the older are progressively back. Okay. And the secondary roots further branch and rebranch to form tertiary root or rootlets. Okay. Tertiary root or rootlets. Then next. Roots are protected by a particular cover. Okay. Or cap. Root cap. Or called as calyptra. At this growing tips, okay, at its growing tips, if you take the example here, you can see, suppose, so, such type of cap you, okay, so root cap or root cap or calyptra. So next, and behind the root tip top, a unicellular outgrowth are present, are called root hairs. Okay, so roots, root hair also we found. Okay, the next function, what is the function of root? So it enhances or encourages, it encourages the plant and penetrate the soil which help for absorption of water and also minerals or ions, and it need for plant nutrition. So mainly roots help for plant nutrition or plant better development. So what he do? Plant absorbs the water and mineral ion which is helpful for plant development, okay, or plant growth. The next, second is our stem. It is the overground part. From the root, then second part is come stem, okay. Stem is come. The stem is overground part. We can see upperly, but in the root is just inside the soil, okay. And develop the, and the stem mainly develop the pumil of the seed. If you take the example of a seed, okay, from the, remember, if you it is seed, from the radicle root develop, okay, and here from the here pimple, from the pimple our shoot or stem part is developed. Got it? From a seed, radicle is at two parts, okay, really is developed upward and also downwards. So downwardsly root part develop radicle, from the radicle and the pimple develop upwardly, and from the pimple shoot our stem are developed. Okay, upper growth part is done. Remember this one. So stem may be branched or unbranched. In case of unbranched, palm plants, okay, and also different into nodes and internodes. I mean differentiated into nodes and internodes. So in nodal region, leaves and branch are arises, and internodal region is distance between two adjacent nodes. Okay, if you take example here, you the main axis is here. Okay, so this part is where the branch are developed. This part, okay, this part is known as node. This part is known as node. Okay, and between the two node, here also node, because branches develop here. So between the distance between the two nodes, this part is known as internode. Got it? So next, stem bears lateral branches, buds, leaves, flowers, fruit, and also defense organ. The defense organ means spine, prickles and stiff hairs, which are helpful for protection. Okay, if outer animals or other organism are attack the plant body, that time the defense organ are helpful for plant. Okay, the next, function, helpful for specific function and conduction for minerals. Okay, same, quite same as roots. Okay, so after root absorption the water and minerals, it also it transfer to the stem. Okay, and stem is just help for conduction for minerals and waters. Okay, the next is our leaves. Here the leaves. So leaves, leaves are, what is leaves? Lateral outgrowths. Okay, leaves are mainly lateral outgrowths and rises from nodes of the stem or its branches. Leaves may be developed directly from the nodes or from the branches. Okay, if you take the here like this. Okay, this is main axis, mother axis. Okay, the plant may be like this. From the branch, the leaf is developed, or directly from the nodal region, the leaves are developed likewise. Okay, leaf. Okay, got it. All the leaves of plant are collectively called foliage. Okay, the leaves are mainly called as foliage. Leaf has three parts: leaf base, petiole, and lamina. So here you can see this part is our lamina, this part is leaf base, and the stalk. The stalk part is our petiole. Okay. Got it? The next, leaf lamina bears vane and venation. Here you can see the leaf lamina. Okay. It has this part. Okay. Different vane and vane, this main vane and different venation. Okay. Vanelets. Vane and vanelets. Sorry. Vane and vanelets. The next function. Helpful for photosynthesis, respiration, and gaseous exchange. Okay. The next, buds. A bud is a considered or underdeveloped young shoot. It bears, it becomes active or remain dormant for indefinite period. Example, cold country plants. Okay, in case of cold country plants where the winter buds goes in dormant. Okay, it goes in dormant stage till favorable condition or favorable season not comes. Okay, so why they go for dormancy? Because in winter the development of the bud is not possible at this region, so they become dormant. Okay, and after waiting for a favorable condition, then they develop properly. Buds are said to be covered or closed when they are protected by overlapping scales, hair, waxes, coating, or resin. For example, such type of buds we found: ficus, calotropis, digipos, okay, etc. In tropical plants, buds mostly naked. Okay, in case of tropical plant, on the basis of their position on stem, the buds may be apical, axillary, or accessory. Okay. Apical, inapical, the present in terminal, upper part, terminal, apex, okay, axillary, side, laterally, and maybe accessory type. Okay, here the apical buds responsible for increasing plant height, because in they develop at tip region and they develop. Okay, so the increasing in plant height. Axillary bud, lateral branches, they develop lateral branches from the axillary buds. Lateral branches are developed. Okay, and from the accessory, it develop on the side or collateral, otherwise it's called collateral, or above sideways superpose the axillary bud. Okay, usually give rise for stem modification. So the accessory bud mainly helpful for stem modification. The next is flower. So it is a reproductive suit for sexual reproduction. A typical or a complete flower has four holes. Okay, four parts. They made up of four holes mainly. First one is calyx, corolla. Second one is, third one is androecium, and fourth one is gynoecium. Okay, so here first one is calyx. Outermost hole consists of the sepal. What is the calyx? Really, calyx is the plural form. Okay, and the singular, the single one. Okay, if you here take the in case of flower. Okay, so suppose you just take the flower here. Okay, so here so this part the hole is known as the calyx, and the single appendage is known as the sepal. Okay, so the outermost hole consists of sepal. Usually green meant for protection of the other holes in the bud stage. When we see the flower in a bud stage, okay, in a bud stage, what happens? This sepal or calyx cover the other hole parts. That means they cover the corolla, androecium and gynoecium inside it. Okay, and it give the protection to them. Got it? So the next is come corolla. Collection of petal. The second is petal, our corolla. This part, okay, single part is petal. Got it? Okay, suppose this is a hibiscus plant. Okay, so the collection of petal is known as corolla. Okay, inner to it represents inner to calyx. It is colorful for attract insects for pollination. Okay, this is most important thing. The corolla or the petals are colorful because they attract to insect for their pollination. Pollination is most important for their reproduction time. Okay, different insects are helpful for their reproduction because the pollination is done by insects, then only the reproduction done in plant or the flowers. Okay, the third is androecium, third or male hole, the male hole. Okay, the male body. Collection of stamens. Okay, collection of stamen is androecium. Each stamen is a modified leaf or microsporophyll. Okay, so otherwise known as microsporophyll. Remember this word. Okay, microsporophyll. The next, here you can see the stamen. Stamen has mainly three parts: filament, connective and anther. Here the diagram. Anther, this joining part, the anther and the filament. Joining part is connective and this part is filament. So this is all about stamen structure. Anther is filled with pollens within pollen sac. Okay, so anther is filled with pollens. It bears the pollens. Okay, so where the pollens grains, the pollens are present in pollen sac. Got it? The pollens are present in pollen sac. Okay, then third, our female reproductive part, our here gynoecium or pistil, female hole. Okay, collection of carpel. Okay, the group of carpel is known as gynoecium. Okay, this is single one and this is plural hole. Each carpel has three parts. It has three parts like anther. So carpel has three parts: stigma, style and ovary. Here if you take the example here diagram, this part is swollen part is stigma, this longer part is style, and it bears the ovary. Okay, in ovary ovular present. Okay, so this is the part of carpel. Got it? The next, stigma receive the pollen and ovary is the bear swollen part. Okay, so here the stigma, what happened here, the stigma bears the pollen grain. Here the pollen grain comes and touch to the or contact to the stigma. Okay, for the next, what for the fertilization? Okay, the reproduction, first reproduction is done between our ovary, ovule, and our pollen. Okay, so from this part, the pollen grains enters into the ovary and come close to ovules for the fertilization. Okay, so here stigma receive the pollen grains, pollens, and ovary is the bare stolen part of carpel that bears one or more ovules. Okay, here you can say one and more ovules are present. Each ovules encloses an embryo sac. Okay, encloses by an embryo sac which contain an egg cell. Okay, inside the ovule, one on ovule, an embryo sac is present. Okay, and embryo sac has egg cell. Okay, so the egg cell and the pollen grains. Okay, the here you see the ovule. Ovule has the embryo sac, and embryo sac bear the egg cell. Okay, and the pollen grain into get inserted. Stigma, then style, then ovary inside the embryo sac. Okay, after fertilization, ovary develop into a fruit. Okay, which bear many seeds. Then fertilization done, after complete the fertilization, it's become seeds. Seeds consist of seed coat and embryo. This embryo later consists of one or two cotyledon. It may be one or two. Okay, the seed consists of the cotyledon attached to embryo axis or trilizium. Okay, the next, one end of trilizium called plumule, which gives rise to shoot, and this and the other end is called radicle, grown into shoot. What I already told you, from the seed, if the seed is here already, this is picture, is developed picture. Okay, the seed already developed, already here you just take the seed. Okay, from the seed, so step up, two parts are developed. Okay, the first stage, and this one is second stage. Got it? So here, from the plumule part, okay, plumule part, one end of trilizium. Okay, plumule part, the what do we see here? The shoot system. Shoot system are developed, and below the downwardly other end, the from the radicle, this one is plumule, okay, plumule, and from the radicle, the shoot system is developed. So from the shoot system, so root hairs are developed. Got it? From the plumule, shoot system developed, and from the radicle, root system developed. Remember always. Okay, so this video for fundamental of a morphology and the angiospermic plant. So if you want a descriptive type of video for in this angiospermic morphology of angiospermic plant, please comment me on comment section. I will make you video for you first time, because I really like to make video for you. And thank you so much. If you like the video, please click on like button, comment, subscribe the botany channel. And if you want such type of video, hit on bell icon to get regular updates. Thank you so much.